Imagine you lived on a different planet, far out in the stratosphere, and you peered down at the world, say, 60 years ago. You see the hustle and bustle of commerce, economic growth, innovation, human rights expansion, and the spreading migration of extended families, often leaving older adults in need of a place to live as their needs change. Hospital-like facilities take shape to house and treat frail elders. Imagine coming back to Earth 30 years later, in 1990. Nursing homes exist in nearly every community, and they look and feel mostly like an institution. But you notice something different happening in a corner of upstate New York. A young doctor, Bill Thomas, the medical director of a small nursing home, visits an elder with a rash on her arm. As doctors do, he prescribes an ointment and is about to leave when the elder utters these words, "I'm so lonely." Nothing on his prescription pad can soothe the pain of loneliness. This statement forever changes this doctor's life. Dr. Thomas determined a solution to this plague of institutional living must be found, and what he later identifies as the three plagues of the institution: loneliness, helplessness, and boredom. He founds a nonprofit organization, the Eden Alternative, seeking to abolish these plagues in long-term care. Time passes and you get curious about what is happening on planet Earth. You return a little over a decade later and see Dr. Thomas with a blank sheet of paper, envisioning a new kind of living environment for elders, reimagining what a real home could be like if not confined by brick and mortar or the typical hierarchical structure and institutional practices of a traditional facility. He calls it the greenhouse model. His vision is for elders to be the bosses and be in control of their daily lives. Guided by this vision, the first four greenhouse homes open in Tupelo, Mississippi in 2003. Steve McAlilly of Mississippi Methodist Senior Services says, "I believe that the quality of life in a community is defined by the way the community treats its elders. And if you find a community that engages the elders in all of life, you're going to find a place that's a good place to live, and life's good." These first four greenhouse homes are soon joined by six additional homes. You're curious, what exactly is this radical new approach to caring for elders? What makes these small homes so different? Three driving approaches, called core values, guide this new model of care. Real home. A deinstitutionalized living environment builds upon the belief that humans thrive in an environment that is warm, smart, and real. The homes are small with private rooms for each elder, inviting living and dining spaces for all, and accessible outdoor areas. It's a true home and community of belonging, not just a home-like facility for those who live there. Meaningful life. At the root of this model is relationship-rich, person-directed living, in which life is centered around the elder, each of whom exercise choice, control, and autonomy in daily life. Individual needs are met in a greenhouse home because each person is deeply known. There are opportunities for purposeful engagement, and each elder is valued for their creativity and resourcefulness. Empowered staff. The organizational structure in the greenhouse model is a complete departure from the traditional nursing home hierarchy. In a greenhouse home, the staff model is flattened to create a circular organizational chart with the elders at the center. Shabazin, the direct care staff who work as self-managed team members, have primary responsibility for the day-to-day care of the elders and the daily functioning of the homes. They utilize a shared decision-making process, which is supported by a collaborative coaching culture in which nurses and clinical support team members work in partnership with the Shabazin to meet the needs of the elders. You wonder, this seems to work well in Tupelo, Mississippi, but can it be replicated? And then you see the spread of the model across the United States. The model is flexible enough to adapt to different communities, from the downtown areas of major urban cities to the cornfields and farmlands of rural America. It is adapted to meet the needs of elders and individuals living with disabilities across care settings, from skilled nursing to assisted living to short-term rehab. Truly, a greenhouse home can be a home for anyone. It spreads beyond the U.S. across the globe with models happening in Australia, Europe, Canada. Over 400 homes, impacting thousands and thousands of elders' lives, exist under the greenhouse model. You sense a real movement in long-term care, and it's just the beginning.